So get ready for the long haul of some whistling time. Oh.
So you're invisible, you're hiding. Mm-hmm. You have fainted and crumpled into a tent-faced form on the floor. So he's gonna strike at one of you three.
Okay.
One, two, three.
Four, nice.
Madam Beatrice.
No!
He goes to shove the blade part of his bayonet right through her dirty, dirty heart. Do you want to stop this?
Yes!
How are you going to do it?
I'm going to pull out a different potion.
Well, you've got a dead snake in your hand. It's going to be really hard to do that.
I'm going to hold the snake and pull a potion out of my other.
On the other side of your coat, you have potions?
Oh, yeah, look, I even drew them.
So snake's on one side and potions.
True, he's got potions.
And that's the right side?
That's
right.
That is the correct side.
Well, okay then.
Good forethought. All right, so.
You can replace Beatrice as the fortune teller after that.
Which potion are you trying to pull out?
This is an igniting potion.
Because you're going to pull out a potion no matter what. But whether or not it's an igniting potion, we'll find out.
Okay.
All right. So roll to pull out a potion.
Shit.
Ooh, I like that.
That's a bad start.
That doesn't change anything. You got
a four.
Ugh.
Ooh.
You pull a bubbling, slightly glowing vial of igniting potion out of your coat. Dead snake held in the other hand. Igniting potion in one. Raise the loft. What are you doing?
I'm going to put it into the snake and then throw it at him.
This is a multi-step process that you're trying to do in the split second before the skewers.
Very complicated.
The potion only works inside of
only
snake.
Only, of course.
Yeah,
that's how they work.
Okay, yeah.
It combusts inside of snakes.
Make another potions roll. Okay, and this is going to be a level 2 difficulty.
Will you
Oh! Shit.
So.
It's a good song.
What is it?
What is she whistling?
It's a Hunger Games.
No idea.
Right?
So you pour
whistling the Hunger Games
theme. To the mocking are you chase.
You pour an igniting potion down
but
the throat of this dead snake.
Do we have
snake.
To answer? I can't whistle. I can't whistle.
I can't either.
Somebody else do a whistle.
I don't know.
Do the thing.
Is that
I
what you have to do? You don't
back.
Know.
I don't know.
I don't know.
And she can't tell you.
I don't know what that is.
I don't know what's happening.
I can't whistle either, so I can't do it.
Okay.
Do we have to, like, do the district salute?
I don't. More like, I don't. We shoot them with an arrow.
Do we?
Moving on, your snake ignites. And what were you going to do with this?
Throw it at him.
You were going to throw it at him. Okay, so you do. And it
flaming
wraps itself
snake.
Around his neck in a coiling, fiery ribbon of snake fire.
Got him!
But it's too late to save Madame Beatrice.
No!
A split second too late as he stabs her through the heart. And she turns to look at you, coughing blood out of her mouth and also sending her one tooth flying into your mouth.
No! No!
I'm gonna faint!
You probably fainted.
Okay.
You were coming to.
Oh, but then I fainted.
And started
again.
To stand up and there was. No.
Yep.
That
happened.
I'm going to do a bizarrely morbid magic trick.
Oh God, what are you gonna do? She's about to deliver a touching message, but go ahead.
Is she going to deliver a touching message?
No, please, by all means, interrupt her.
Is she dead yet?
Not yet.
I'm going to,
fucking whistling.
I'm going to project the illusion.
I don't know.
The illusion of Madame Beatrice.
I don't know the catalog.
This is why it's the Wheel of Madness.
And Murphy sharing a tender, intimate moment. For Murphy in his moment of need.
Okay.
But it's definitely her corpse, probably.
Okay, so roll to do, what is the full name of your skill?
Bizarrely Morbid Magic Tricks.
Bizarrely Morbid Magic Tricks.
Can we take those out first?
Take those out. Take those out.
Take them out. Roll for this.
Thank you.
You can make it a skill.
I'm gonna make it a skill. Give me that Bizarrely Morbid Magic Trick.
Nice.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
So, as she goes, still speared on the end of the blade part of the bayonet, to deliver her touching last words to Murphy, she actually dies. At which point, you sneak up behind her, and using her face like a puppet, you use your ventriloquism to mimic her voice and say, what do you say? A touching moment that you're creating a mockery of.
Murphy.
What is?
You've always been the one for me, and I will never forget the smell of your shrimp breath.
You're all amazed. How is she talking? She's dead.
The smell of your shrimp breath and the vague, buttery grease that lingered on your mustache that night. It'll always remain with me, Murphy.
These are very long last words.
I'm dead now.
Oh, whoop, she died. Oh!
Wow.
She told me she was gonna die.
So wait, so you gained a skill rank.
I gained a skill.
Good God.
So that was
whatever bizarrely morbid magic tricks levels up to.
That's going to be perverting tender moments for...
I'm sure that'll be useful.
And the giant figure would also be amazed at this woman who was dead delivering this weird last speech to you, except there is a flaming snake tied around his neck, and he is freaking out and stumbles outside of the tent, tearing at his neck and off into a nearby copse or copse of trees.
You bastard, I'll kill you for this!
Okay, now hold on. Let's take a quick break to figure out what Megan's doing.
What Megan is whistling.
Wow, she's...
I'll give you guys a minute.
That's what it sounds like.
Is she whistling Harry Potter? I
don't... Oh, that's so much better.
X-Files?
What?
With an assist from Dom Zook, the group successfully figured out that Megan was whistling the X-Files
theme
song.
Whistle the tune of a TV show just enough to be annoying until someone names that TV show.
Okay, although, in fairness, it did not sound like the X-Files.
At all. No. No. I cannot whistle, and you know that,
it
but that's fine.
It sounded like Mockingjay.
Yeah, that's what I was like, what do we need to do?
You picked a hard show.
It's the only one I could think of. I grew up watching that show.
Couldn't think of Friends?
Compulsion.
I would have got that.
Compulsion ended.
How do you whistle a quadruple clap?
No, that didn't read to me. Not so much. All right. So whatever it is has gone stumbling from the tent. Oh. You're just left with darkness, a can of beard mace, weird face painting. You're under the table, so you
but
missed everything.
Yeah.
And your lady love, sort of, has died in your arms. But at least you got a like last thing about your shrimp breath and your weird greasy butter fingers.
It's very specific, yeah.
Surf and turf.
Surf and turf.
It's weird because it was lobster, it wasn't shrimp, and you're pretty, but like, you know, when you're dying,
sometimes
you
got lobster for sure.
You got lobster. Yeah.
They smell vaguely similar.
Did she give us instructions on how to get to the generator tent?
No. She did not, for she is a fortune teller.
I finally got the skill that I wanted, so I'm going to try again to find something that might be horribly flammable to my beard, and hopefully it's the generator.
All right, I'm going to start digging.
Let's try it.
No, it isn't.
Why are you going to dig?
This is an electrical cord down here somewhere.
No, on my page, that is removing the random element of it and just giving me what the NPC is. The normal NPC donation is still in play. I didn't put that on my page. I was very confused about how to run Extra Life stuff. The normal NPC donation is still on. $25 for a random NPC, but for $100, they can just tell me what that NPC is like and everything about it.
I'm sorry, Cape Carly.
So what did they pay for?
I don't know.
Oh,
so ask him if he wants a limerick, the bastard, or if he wants an NPC instead. Anyway, sorry. Ignore that. That was nothing. Sorry. You guys were saying.
You know, Buzz, maybe if you weren't such a useless, crappy electrician, none of us would be in this mess. Why are you digging?
Hold on. Buzz. I can only assume you're saying that to the air, because none of you have any idea where Buzz is.
He
vanished.
Buzz is gone.
Is under the table, just retreating to a very dark place.
Mentally and physically.
Yeah, no, like his depression is kicking in.
Roll for that.
Is this supposed to be a hand with fingers made of bullets?
It's just
it does kind of look that way.
Yeah, but I want that to be a skill though.
Okay, so you can't help but be optimistic in the face of all this adversity, but you do feel the tendrils of your crushing depression sneaking in.
Okay, good.
Thank you very much. So you gain crushing depression too.
It's not just regular depression.
No. Mm-mm. If it was, it wouldn't be a skill.
Yeah. It's on the edges of my vision, but this isn't really getting to me right now. I hid. It was the best thing to do. And I know that if I start digging, I will find an electrical cord. Eventually.
An electrical gourd?
An electrical gourd.
Nope, he said gourd. That's canon.
He said gourd.
That's a surprising electrical fact.
Right?
That's how pumpkins work.
So you guys are looking for the tent, but he's looking for a gourd.
A magical electrical gourd.
Wait, that's what you're looking for?
And all the wires route through it.
What the fuck are you talking
trust
about?
Trust me, I'm the electrician here, okay?
Don't trust him. He's an idiot.
I kind of believe in her at this point.
Yeah, I think that's a good point.
Ooh. It has been stated. All right,
yeah.
So.
Yeah, that is a good point.
Where are we going?
And she does make good points.
I do. Yeah. I do. I'd like to follow where this monster went.
What?
Running
no.
randomly.
I will slay this thing.
No.
It slayed my woman.
Nope.
Running randomly
the
off into
box.
The copses or copses of trees?
Let's.
Electrical
well, let's turn the lights on so I can see him.
Yes, let's do that.
Yes.
Yeah.
Look for
on board. All
right.
So we're looking for the main generator
yes.
tent.
Yes.
So what do we know about the main generator tent so far? Let's review.
Put our heads together.
It exists.
Like a family.
Yes. It definitely exists according to two people.
What the
hell?
What?
No.
Oh shit. No.
Sex is a coward. He runs from the room as soon as he starts. No.
Come on.
No.
What?
No.
Oh.
Ah, no!
No! Oh, no! Oh, no. He appeared for just a moment!
Oh, God!
What's happening?
Oh, no. God!
My boo!
I only have, like, three bears!
I'm reloading!
Why does half of it not fire?
The only thing I'll get is your face, and it'll be better. That's right. Right, you better run!
Are we cool? Are we cool? Oh, we thought we were cool!
Don't be a pussy, Sax.
He's like Jason goddamn Bourne with that thing.
He's doing the Don Jam.
Damn it.
All right, are we cool? Are we cool? Are we, hold on, we're cool. We're cool. We're cool. We're cool. We're cool. Everybody, we're cool.
Cool.
All right, he's out.
I'm out anyway.
Are we chill?
We're cool. Stop shooting. We're cool. We're supposed to be cool.
Sorry, I just want one more.
Is there more to this or just?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Something happened.
I understand.
Something happened.
When that thing unhappens, let me know. All right, so yes, it definitely exists according to at least a handful of people. Legend tells it is somewhere near the Wild Mouse roller coaster.
Ah!
Yes!
Which also probably sets things up.
And it is guarded.
Well,
maybe.
Do I still have night vision with my potion?
I don't know how long a night vision potion lasts. Yeah. I assume all night. Yeah. Otherwise, what would be the point?
I could probably see this roller coaster.
Yeah, you probably could if you took the time to look.
Where is it?
Oh, it's right over there.
There it is!
Oh!
It's on the other side of an open clearing. You see the clear outline of the Wild Mouse roller coaster. Still running for some reason.
It's finally on. There's power there.
Behind it, the outline, vague though it may be, of a tent.
Let's go!
Now
let's
that
go.
Could be the snack tent.
Well,
it's
then
hard to tell
at
from
least
this distance.
There are snacks.
Well, that's true, but we should at least try.
Yeah.
Onward, carnies!
All right, so the glowing green-eyed guy leads you over to the Wild Mouse roller coaster. When striding out from the ticket booth comes Jillian Duchovny. That's right.
Yes.
Oh.
BSB yes. Care has added Jillian Duchovny, I think, initially to try and help Megan out. That time has passed due to my confusing instructions. So, Jillian Duchovny, the affectionate, undead,
oh, good.
Yeah. Oh boy,
monster.
Okay.
A lot of recurring themes here tonight.
Yeah. It's good. It's fine.
So she comes shambling out. I say she, it's really hard to tell. Because it's just kind of like a big amorphous blob that looks to be an amalgamation of several different parts.
I faint.
Yep. Wait, yeah. Hold on.
What?
No, okay, you faint.
Okay, now I'm okay.
I'm restringing my bow. Comes wandering out of the ticket booth, or schlorping. Comes schlorping out of the
schlorping.
Ticket booth.
Oh, yeah. As one does.
Yeah.
No. Have you guys seen my daddy?
What the fuck?
You guys look like friends.
Ignore. Just completely walk past this thing.
Wait. Does she count as an unpleasant person?
No, she's being very nice. Just unpleasant to look at.
Hold on. I've never met friends before. But have you seen my dad?
Have you seen the electrical tent?
I don't know. I was just born a few hours ago.
Wait.
Can you describe your dad for us?
He's real tall and real smart, and he has a bayonet, which everybody knows, he told me, is a gun with a blade attached to it. I've learned so much in the few hours I've been alive.
That son of a bitch killed the love of my life.
My dad did?
Yeah.
No, he's really nice.
No, not at all.
Yeah, he didn't murder several people.
He gives me big hugs like this.
And she takes like four and a half of her arms and just kind of like wraps them around herself.
Oh.
He's nice.
That's disconcerting.
Mm.
But you guys can be my friends.
I have an idea. What if we start killing her? Her dad's bound to show, and then we kill him too.
I don't know what that word means.
Don't agree.
But maybe we can use her as leverage, and we tie up all of the arms.
I'm merely an innocent born to this world. What does kill mean?
Hey, why don't you come with us?
Okay. No reason not to trust you.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes. We need to find a box.
Okay.
Of light.
Okay.
Can you help us?
Yep.
Okay.
But first, if you can tell me what any of those words are, that would be helpful.
Fingernail, like a fully formed fingernail just kind of like plops out of her mouth.
Sorry, that happens sometimes. My stomach was accidentally routed through my endocrine system.
Okay. So maybe
we should just read on it like just.
Now bring her with
she
us.
She seems fine.
She seems very friendly.
I almost like attractive. Meeting people.
She's good. What? Does someone keep that? Murphy away from her?
Do you mean
her?
That? Yeah. Murphy, do you mean that?
I do.
Then I won't make you roll for it.
Murphy, what is this with you?
You seem kind of nice.
Thank you. I think you're nice too.
We're we going to find the blocks with the locks in it.
You like roller coasters? Yes. We're going to the roller coaster.
I live under a roller coaster.
You live? Oh, okay.
This is my
Have
house.
Have you seen a fabric
Madonna.
House?
You're just born.
What?
You know
a
Madonna?
Tent.
Everybody knows Madonna.
You know that word? And person?
Have you seen a tent?
A tent. Can you describe it?
It's fabric.
Okay.
House.
Okay. Yep.
Can
it's
you
right behind the roller coaster.
Show us where it is.
That's the house that Daddy lives in. I'm not supposed to go there. I live under the roller coaster.
Two birds with one stone. Let's go.
You should come and say hi to your dad.
Kay.
It's us.
And stand in front of us.
Yeah. She starts slurping.
You should lead us.
So she's standing in front of you?
Yeah.
Come on. Mm-hmm. I'll take you to Dad's house.
And she starts kind of trundly slurping off in that direction. around and behind the Wild Mouse coaster. Are you guys following her?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very closely.
Sure. So you follow her.
A little too closely.
A little too closely.
How closely?
Very closely.
Now, I recall that you tried to flirt.
I did earlier.
Did you gain a skill in
it? I didn't.
You did not, because you sucked at it.
Yeah.
That's fine. I was just checking.
You have a thing for the undead, I believe.
I guess so.
Or the
that
very
has disturbing connotations.
The nearly dead.
Let's keep going right past that.
We're
along with our gentle,
dead.
Our gentle, innocent
dead.
Story for families.
People in a big proximity of death.
Yeah. Yeah.
Near dead people.
Nearly dead.
Recently
people.
Dead
Mostly
people.
Dead.
Right. Anyways, mostly dead is slightly alive.
That's
this
true.
Is a trick, and I'm not falling. I'm not going to keep talking about this. We're going to go over to the main generator tent.
Yeah, going to distract
objective.
Me.
She's slurping that way. Mm-hmm. So you guys from around here?
You yep. can say that.
We live yeah. here.
No way.
Yeah.
Me too.
Oh, good. We're neighbors.
Where do you
Great.
Live?
Under the roller coaster. Remember?
Yes. Did you ever live anywhere else?
Nope.
Okay.
As I stated, I was born several hours
yeah.
ago.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
That's good.
One of her feet just kind of like comes, an extra foot comes out of her side and just goes down.
This will help stabilize me.
Does any of her look like
skill.
Brady?
Sure.
Oh, no!
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Part of her does.
So okay. she's sort of a meat,
It's like
meat
the
meat
left bone. Pectoral.
Yeah, that's Brady's pectoral.
Yeah, you could tell because there's a tattoo mm-hmm. of a maid, like a smiling maid, just like right in the middle of his pectoral muscle. And yeah. she's just kind of like, she's got shifty eyes, like she's looking all around her.
One of the eyes is her nipple.
Yeah.
It's his nipple.
You nailed it. You hit the nail on the head.
I yeah. really wish that the county insurance would cover the therapy I will need from this.
Well. There is no amount of therapy that can...
All right, new friends, here's the tent.
Why don't you go in first?
Kay!
So she goes inside the tent, and long moments pass. No noise comes from within. Just the crickets and the night birds.
You guys coming?
No. Jesus.
Yeah.
Are there any weapons nearby? Or things that could be weapons?
I don't know. You tell me. Roll for it.
I have some weapons. Hey, I could probably
find more. It's a Hyper Rabbit Power Team Go Raid right now.
The quill! The quill got quilted!
Oh, it's Tom!
Why?
I gotta reload!
Why does Tom get all the good guns?
I'm gonna shoot the camera!
I can see why those are not used anymore!
Oh, no!
I'm out of bullets! I only get three! Ah, oh, gut shot! Oh, it's a gut shot.
Are we
cool?
Are we cool? You hit him right on the top of the head. That was an awesome shot.
Nice.
I have a certain set of skills.
Whoa. Welcome, everyone.
Yeah, thanks for coming in.
Thanks.
Woo! Is that from our friends at Hyper RPG or
Hyper Rabbit something something? Doc said.
Oh my!
Welcome to the show.
Welcome, good friends.
So I destroyed this quilt, but I'll fix that. While you tell me, you're gonna cast about for a weapon.
Oh yeah.
Cast about for a weapon.
Oh yeah, yeah. I'm gonna get
guy who produces potions and snakes from.
There's a roller coaster nearby.
Yep.
So I'm gonna walk over and just pull one of the boards from the roller coaster.
That's a wooden coaster. Much more deadly than a death potion.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
so
one of those.
Pull out a board. Roll for that.
Okay. God damn it.
Ooh.
Okay. So you successfully pull a board.
Yeah.
Out from the roller coaster. Unfortunately, it was the load-bearing board. And the entire roller coaster comes slowly crashing down in front of
your
terrified eyes. Don't worry.
Is it
slurping? Falls away from you guys.
Our new friend is going to be very mad that you broke her house.
And she is. You turn around and she just watches astonished as her world crumbles in front of her.
No.
That was not a good idea.
No, wait. Oh, hold on, wait. You deserve better than that. I'm gonna build you a new house.
My home.
Starting with this piece of wood. Right now.
Are you lying?
I'm gonna plug it into the ground.
Are you going to build her a new house starting with that piece of wood?
I am. I plug it into the ground. Step
do
one.
Do you mean it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of course I do.
I will wire that home.
Oh, this is a fire hazard waiting to happen.
I'll paint it for you.
I will.
Will you paint pretty things on it, like a cat throwing up and a cheeseburger?
Yes.
Throwing up. Also throwing up. It's like we're on the same brain page.
I know. I'm gonna. I can't pervert this tender moment. It's already perverted.
You could make it worse.
I could make it.
You try.
Want to? I could make it
try.
Worse.
Do you want to pervert this time?
I'm gonna make it worse.
Just try.
I have a lot of. I have four of these.
Then do it. Pervert this tender moment. But as you said, it will be hard because it's already pretty weird.
Yeah.
So you got a 10?
10.
Okay. Yep.
Yep.
Wow.
Okay.
So please tell me how.
What's her name again?
Jillian Duchovny.
Jillian Duchovny. Jillian Duchovny.
You can remember it because she's like a composite of those two characters from Mockingjay.
Right. Sure. Yep. She slowly extends her tongue and
this is you or she's doing
No, she's doing
it. Oh, I was going to say, that's weird.
I'm perverting this moment by making it worse.
Okay.
But making it more perverted. And her tongue keeps extending.
Well, no, hold on. When you do this, you have to act upon the moment in order to pervert
it. I have to do
it. You don't take narrative control.
Okay.
That's a six level
skill. I reach over and I grab her tongue.
Okay.
And I pull it out.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
And I wrap it slowly around his face.
Oh.
Until he's becoming a tongue mummy. Slowly.
Wow.
Slowly becoming a tongue mummy.
This is a new thing for me.
My life.
It's wrapping around his face.
And you all have to watch.
Then,
oh God!
All of you.
And once it's reached the top of his head, I take two of her arms.
Okay.
And I wrap them around his body.
This is just you killing me. This is what you've
done. This is literally murder.
You're just murdering me.
And then I dust them both in glitter.
Wow.
I'm not sure why I did that. Just
she spins you around rapidly.
Yeah.
That was the most intimate thing I've ever experienced.
In your 3 hours of life.
Yeah, it's a low bar. You guys coming into the tent?
Yeah. So do you think you could maybe tell your dad that, like, we're cool?
Yep. Next time I see him.
He's not in there now.
No.
Okay. Cool.
We'll just go inside and wait for him to come home, and you can greet, we can greet him together.
Okay.
As new friends. Yeah.
Okay. So he's not home yet.
He's not home yet.
Nope, he said he had to go and, what was the word you used earlier? Kill everyone, I think he said. I assume he's like giving them presents.
Yes. The present of death,
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's sweet, really.
Just like he gave you.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah.
Come on in.
All right.
Okay.
So I go in.
We go into tent.
We go into the darkened interior. So all along the walls of the main generator tent, you see Christmas lights have been strung, and they are all still running because there is a smaller sub-generator, very silent, inside of the main generator tent. Like, so silent you couldn't have followed the noise of it all the way from where you were earlier, trust me. Yeah. And on the walls are taped pictures of each and every one of the carnies that works at this carnival.
Oh.
And over everyone's face is a symbol. Different symbols on everyone's faces. Some have strange, weirdly contorted triangles. Some have like an inverted circle.
Yeah.
And some have even more bizarre symbols than those two that I named.
An upside down triangle, maybe?
It's been spun around 180 degrees.
That's terrifying.
A slightly rotated rectangle.
Can I roll to try to recognize arcane symbols?
Sure.
Probably won't, but let's try it.
Yeah, because you don't do actual magic.
I don't know any actual magic, but maybe I think I do.
Okay.
You've definitely seen some of these before. Mm. You've encountered these through your internet learning.
I learned all
courses.
Of my magic tricks on YouTube.
Yep.
You've
remember seeing some of them posted in the YouTube comments of some of those videos. Mm. And you remember that they were spelled out somewhere, but the meaning eludes you. Some forum you were on, maybe like a Criss Angel fan group forum.
That's probably what it was.
Where someone posted something about this, but you can't remember what it is.
Hey guys, I saw these symbols one time, but I don't remember what they are.
That's really helpful, thank you.
Yeah, thanks for telling us that.
Yeah.
That's great.
That's awesome.
Where's my picture?
Your friends are jerks. Your picture's over in a tiny dusty corner of the main generator tent. Also, just so you guys know, the main generator is also in here. Yeah. that's the dominant feature of the main generator tent. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, just but to, also.
Like, quick aside. Mm-hmm.
So maybe we should like turn that back on.
Yeah, maybe
there is no
that.
Symbol on your picture.
Maybe I'm special. Maybe you
hey,
like
Buzz.
Me.
Yeah.
You want to prove that you're good
maybe
for
not
something
the way you think.
And turn the generator back on.
Yeah, no problem.
any day now, Buzz.
No, yeah. It's one of those switches. So,
not getting any younger, Buzz.
Are you just gonna pull a switch at random? Roll surprising electrical knowledge.
Surprise us!
Ha!
Okay. Wow! Whoa.
Yeah, that was the wrong switch.
Yeah. Yeah, wrong switch.
You hear a. And it starts to smoke.
Okay, all right, that was the smoke machine, I think.
Good instincts.
I turn the switch off.
Okay. The chick grunking subsides, sorry.
All right.
Does not reside. Well, it resides in there when you turn the switch on.
Mm-hmm. Come on, Buzz, we can help. What are you looking for on here?
You know what?
The on switch.
Now, one of those was a six. If you wanted to spend that an experience point into turning that into a skill.
I think I probably should.
Okay. Activating wrong but beneficial effects. 3.
Okay. Perfect.
So you start hearing music coming from somewhere within the park, but then when you flip the switch off, it dies down.
Great. Great. Buzz, you're great. This is like that time you tried to fix my hair dryer, and I ended up with a bald spot on half of my head. It's great. Thanks, Buzz. You're great.
I don't think she means that.
I don't think so either.
Yeah. Oh, I mean it.
It feels like that you were implying the opposite. Maybe that it wasn't great.
I think you're farking, right?
I don't know what you mean. It's great.
Wait, let me talk
this to... This sounds like farking, and I'm, I've been around farking for a good 15 minutes now, so I think I know a farking when I hear one.
Let me talk to Jillian. Does she know, I mean, if her dad lives here or something?
Are you asking me?
Jillian.
Jillian?
Yeah.
Jillian.
Why did you use such weird tense when talking to me?
I didn't know.
It was confusing.
I didn't know if you knew your own name. So
yeah,
I wanted to
Jillian Duchovny.
Okay.
My dad lives here.
Do you know how your dad turns on the lights?
Yeah, he flips his switch.
Which one?
Not the one your friend flipped. That just turns on all the carnival's auditory effects.
You want to point him in the right direction?
I don't know.
Oh, it's this one.
Psst. Surprising electrical.
Is it?
Probably not.
No. Look.
Now, would you like to roll activating a wrong but beneficial effect?
Yeah, sure.
In response to that being wrong?
Oh, no!
Four dice for that?
No, three dice.
Okay. That's bad.
Yeah.
But it still wins. So you just turned on all of the carnival's animatronics. You hear them all jangling and janking to life inside of their glass cases. They're all old school animatronics.
In glass cases.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, but
it's
we
a
don't.
Carnival.
But the glass cases are no longer electrified.
Right.
So
they can
escape.
Get them off!
I don't know how.
No, hold on. It was a beneficial effect.
Oh.
So maybe their glass somehow prevents them from escaping. You never really bothered to think about it before now. Maybe they won't escape at all, because they are just animatronics.
Maybe they're just animatronics.
I don't know.
I wouldn't put anything past this carnival.
I think I have to turn on multiple switches.
No, I think you have to do nothing and like it.
Everyone make a roll for me real quick. Everyone opposing that. Whoops.
Oh, no.
Wow.
Wow.
Well, okay.
I
got a one.
I got a six.
So who failed?
I did.
You failed. Did you even roll?
I rolled a two.
You rolled two, you failed two. So you two that got sixes, you got thinking thoughts, too. It occurs to you that possibly you could trace the sounds of the jangling animatronics and form a sort of echo-located map of the carnival through your head, since between all of you, you probably know where all the biggest animatronic features are located.
Wow, what a thought to think. That's crazy.
You guys
look like you're thinking thoughts.
Yeah.
What's
I'm not used to this feeling.
It burns a little.
Yeah.
No, not gonna burn. You're safe. You're totally safe.
It's tingly.
Yeah, it's easy to confuse the two. It's easy. I mean, that time.
Welcome, Nick.
Nick, I'm sorry.
This gun doesn't work.
Nick.
Nick, down goes Nick.
Nick, did I get you in the eye?
Oh, no.
Is that the second time tonight I've shot someone directly in the eye? Are you all right?
Wow. Are you doing this on
No.
Uh-oh. Oh, God. Is he bleeding?
We have an actual nerf injury.
All right. I am retiring from Nerf 4, because earlier I shot Michael right in the eye on accident, and
man.
I shot Nick in the face. So,
yeah.
What
a way to welcome.
This is dangerous stuff.
He's going to be playing the rest of the night with a black eye.
Well, okay.
We'll check back with Nick later, guys.
Yeah. Meanwhile, back in the
studio. Once the bleeding stops.
So, you guys all find that you can navigate through the park by the navigation of the animatronics.
Where do we want to go that's not here?
Away.
Okay.
We still got to turn the lights on.
I don't know if that's going to be possible.
Okay, does it turn the lights on from here?
How many switches are left?
Oh, where does he turn the lights on from?
The front of the carnival.
The front of the carnival.
Okay.
That's where the switch is.
Well, you
turn on the generator and flip the switch.
That's right. He's right. She's right.
I don't identify as any particular gender. I'm made up of many pieces of both.
And I appreciate how progressive you are.
Thanks. Everyone starts off progressive, I guess.
Would you like to come with us?
Nope.
Oh, come on.
No, I'm going to stay here and guard my new house.
No, I think you should come with us.
You're trying to persuade her?
Sure.
Do it.
No.
Okay. No, that's okay. I don't want to do that. I'll stay here. Bye.
I still think.
Bye.
Leverage.
Bye.
Okay.
Leverage.
Bye.
All right, let's go.
Sleep.
To the front.
To the front of wherever.
All right. So you guys can hear the fortune telling booth thing is jangling around, the pirate that tells you where your secret treasure that you'll find on your birthday is, and you know, the rest of them, the one that makes french fries.
Yeah. Is there one that makes people big?
No. You got one that makes them smaller.
Yeah, and monsters.
Yeah, and also monsters.
Monsters.
Fabio must have paid a visit to that one.
Can we have one that will make Buzz smart?
Aww. No, sorry. So no animatronic possesses that power.
That makes me very sad. Very, very sad.
Oh, no. Oh, I can't beat that. Your crushing depression comes swooping
darkness,
in.
Darkness, my old friend.
Wait, so crushing depression.
Specifically when Grisabella...
Hold on. Okay. We'll call it paralyzing insecurity.
Tyler's just building himself.
Buzz stops in the middle of the midway and just starts sobbing into
Buzz.
His hands.
Oh, she didn't mean it. Was so mean.
No, yeah, just go on without me. I'm no good. I ain't never been no good to nobody.
Yep, you're right. Let's go. Yep.
I mean, it is a good point.
Man,
but...
she really hates you.
Yeah, right?
Buzz. Buzz, you're coming with us. Kind of
I'm going to carry you if I have to because I'm a good friend.
You're probably going to have to.
All right, I'm gonna carry you.
Will you roll a resist that for me? You do. You got carrying people. Carrying. Carrying two.
Yeah, there's no G in carrying.
There are no G's in roll for shoes.
Yeah.
All skills end in an apostrophe. Murphy is now hauling Buzz towards the front of the park, which you guys are clearly able to navigate to due to all of the jinkity-jankity animatronics.
The jinkity-jankity.
So you find your way up to the main ticket booth. And stumbling out of it comes Jingle Jangles.
Jingle Jangles!
You guys, I thought that you were all dead.
No.
Obviously we're
You're
not.
Okay.
We're harder to kill than that.
Did you see the Ringmaster?
Is that what you call it?
Yeah. An unfortunate side effect of our carnival harvesting the souls of the innocent children that are lured here after dark seems to have released a dark spirit from beyond.
Oh, that's crazy. I don't understand. Like, how does that fall?
I don't know. I inherited
That's just unlucky. Is how
I inherited this from my dad.
I really should warn you about that.
Ear just starts sliding down the side of her face.
When you get into the
hereditary masters.
You faint? Is anyone going to catch her?
No.
Oh, no.
Nope. You are just severe. I'm going to give you a skill. Because you have fainted so many times without being caught. You gain severely concussed.
All right.
You earned it.
Thanks.
He's gonna kill everyone, probably. I mean, that's what he was whispering to himself when he killed most everyone. When I was there. Mm. I've been hiding in the ticket booth.
Do you know what he wants?
I think to kill everyone,
to kill
but I'm not entirely
like
sure. I didn't ask him.
General murder?
Yeah, this is just contextual clues that I've picked up on.
But you said there's a problem that your father dealt with as well?
Oh, I don't know. He never mentioned this.
Oh, okay.
I had to figure out the whole, like, this carnival sucks kids' souls away, just kind of on the job.
Yeah, I
actually
was... They really should put that on, like, the application.
It's on the back of the tickets.
If you look at the admission tickets,
it's in the fine print.
I mean,
I just feel like there's some legal issues where we're...
No, because we did the fine print, it essentially functions as a waiver, so we're covered.
Fully covered, yeah.
Well, yeah, so does the soul sucking apply to employees too?
Oh, yeah.
That happened to me when I was little. But it's we fixed that.
Oh, okay. I was gonna have to have a talk with HR about that because I.
Good one.
There's a whole department.
it's horrible resources.
I've been trying to find the light switch in here, but I have terrible night vision.
Oh no, I got it.
Neither one of my eyes really work.
I don't think Buzz has got it.
Don't worry, I got this.
I think Murphy's got it.
Hold on, he's got it, you guys.
Yeah. Buzz has got it.
Don't worry, I know this.
I believe in you, Buzz.
This is going to be
what are you ruling?
Wrong but beneficial.
You're leading with that.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is because I got a good feeling about this switch. Ooh. Ooh. Okay.
Okay. Wrong but beneficial. All yep.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. So you try to find the light switch, which is in the ticket booth, and somehow activate a wrong but beneficial effect, mm-hmm. which is the thing that I am about to say.
Mm-hmm. I cannot wait to hear
the
thing that he is about to say.
Yeah. But beneficial
when
effect
he says
is,
wow. I'm going to be just
mm-hmm. I'm going to be floored.
Yeah. You turn on all of the rides.
Uh-huh.
Ah.
But not the lights.
Ah.
Of course.
But
the rides have lights on them?
They do. The rides have lights on them. Mm. You just didn't turn on the lights that string the whole... See, that wasn't that hard, guys.
So, yeah. So
it wasn't that hard. That one I worked really hard to come up with a really lame thing for.
So there are just sort of spinning death things not lit?
No, they're lit now.
Oh, they're lit now.
You turn on the ride lights,
but like
not the light lights.
The paths and like the general areas... Was
that not clear?
The copses have been.
And the bare bulbs that have been strung on strings, like all through the midway, those are not on.
Oh.
But
okay.
The light rides. The ride lights are.
So there's like different pools where the rides are.
Sure.
Dimly lit LED.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so, all right. Hey, you're welcome.
LED. Oh, no. These are incandescent bulbs.
1970s era.
Yeah, for sure.
Well, at this point, we have to assume it's a lost cause to ever turn these lights
on. Yeah, Bob is a lost cause. What's your name? Buzz.
How dare
Buzz
you?
Is a lost cause.
His name is Buzz Mung.
Buzz Mung.
Yeah.
Buzz Mung.
Like
you know
my
what
daddy?
Mung rhymes with? Dung.
Oh, that is harsh.
Oh, fight the pain, also, Buzz. Fight the pain.
But she's not wrong.
It rhymes with fun.
Guys, quick update.
Guy.
Nick appears to be okay.
Yay! He's alive.
And as recompense, Dom is handing him an automatic weapon.
Oh, dear.
Right.
Oh, dear.
And he's going full Rambo with it later.
I'm all right with this.
Okay, yeah. So.
We can stop for you to get shot in the eye, right?
Just keep your eyes open.
But I'm delivering important exposition right now because Jingle Jangle starts talking, and well, she's going to, but then a bayonet blade starts slowly coming out of her mouth.
Hey, you got a line.
That's a new one. I've never seen this one before.
Gotta,
I'm gonna faint.
You know what? I can't beat it. There's no way it would be hard for you to faint.
Quick, see if the gun is attached to it.
You can't tell from this angle.
That's
a weird body part.
That's not
what are you trying to say?
Use your words.
Oh, right. That's no good. I don't speak that.
Crack, crack, crack.
Up from behind her comes the spindly, gangly figure of the ringmaster.
Oh boy.
Oh, no.
Holding the gun part of the bayonet, the blade part is sticking out of her mouth from behind. So he shoved her through the back of her head, he shoved it, and it's out of her mouth. And that's what happened. Here he is.
I would like to... That blade's still in her mouth?
Yep.
I would like to carry her away with the blade in her mouth.
What? Well, it's attached to the gun part.
But if I'm using my skill carrying, maybe it breaks off.
Okay.
Cool.
Okay.
Roll it.
Ooh.
Oh! No.
Against all odds.
I will skill that.
Okay.
You get an experience point.
Yeah, okay. You get the skill of...
This is going to be great whenever you say it. I can't wait.
He's getting ready.
Carrying
he's
people
up.
To safety, 3. Yeah, and against all odds, you try to carry her and break the bayonet blade off of the gun part of the bayonet.
Yeah.
But you don't. But you do pull her off of it and carry her out of the tent as the ringmaster points to each of you in turn and says, "No lights. No life." And starts just wildly stabbing. He doesn't appear to know how to use this.
The most inefficient
way. Can I use detect flammable things to look for a lighter?
Sure. Ooh, that's... Yeah, it's not that hard to find a lighter. Yeah. You find one.
This is a carnival.
In your pocket.
Because I would like... Oh, I forgot I have this.
You're surrounded by carnies.
Because I like... The mace is already pretty bad. I'd like to use the lighter and spray the mace through it.
This guy does
the horrible
hate fire.
Death thing.
So you've got beard mace, which you want to light with a pocket lighter.
Yes.
Spray into the face of the ringmaster.
That's a great idea.
Okay. you're using beard mace and you're using a lighter. We'll combine resourceful beard with detect inflammable objects and kind of marry the two to give you two dice for this roll.
Two dice, all right.
No.
Okay. Oh. So you start spraying the bear mace and turn on the lighter underneath it, and a jet of flame shoots out. And then it's so surprising that it happens that you release the nozzle on the bear mace and it sucks all of the flame back into the can of bear mace, which explodes in your hand, lighting your beard on fire.
No!
It's not gone, it's just on fire. And your hand is gone. Your hand is definitely gone.
Okay.
But just your right one. Your left hand is fine.
Well, I mean, so long as I still have most of my beard, it's cool. I don't need that hand.
You now are handless with a flaming beard.
Okay.
But it almost worked.
That's the name of my punk band. Handless with a flaming beard.
So he seems momentarily taken aback by that and ceases stabbing at all of you with his bayonet.
I'm going to magic wand him.
Okay.
With it.
Yeah. To... You know what? Just roll it.
We'll figure it out.
Well.
Thank you. Ooh, so you had a seven?
I had seven.
Okay. So you fail.
And we all die.
You tried to make a rabbit come out of his hat, but you didn't have, you never touched his hat ahead of time to install the secret compartment with the rabbit in it.
Right.
So nothing happens. But the force with which you shout that a rabbit's gonna come out of his hat seems to startle him, and he waits expectantly for something to happen, but it never does, and he gets bored and starts stabbing you all again. So he is coming.
Paint on him.
You have paint?
Yeah.
You've had paint this whole time.
I painted my face, didn't I?
Sure.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Two.
Throwing paint on him.
Oh, come on. Come on.
Pretty easy to resist having paint thrown on you.
You throw some paint and he steps to the side. And he starts trying to stab you with your beard still alight. You're the most readily available target since you're flaming. So he's going to try and stab you. You're going to have to roll the dodge.
Who?
Her. Yeah, sorry. So. Juliet.
Juliet.
Yes.
All right, so I'm going to borrow this.
Do I roll one?
You roll one because you don't have dodge. Ooh, you do not dodge.
You's getting stabbed.
Yep.
Wow. You get stabbed through the abdomen with the bayonet.
Oh.
And he tries to twist it inside of your body, but you manage to back off in time, and you are holding your stomach wound together, but you are...
I was wondering if I was close enough, so long as I'm on the blade, and my beard is still mildly on fire.
Right.
If I could just reach out and try and set him on fire with my beard.
Holy shit. Yeah. You can do that. Did I break it again?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's okay.
It's all right. It's worth it.
Wow. That would be resourceful beard.
That's a very resourceful beard.
I'm getting real
beard.
Good at fixing this. All right. Yeah. Resourceful. Nope. Shit. Ignore that.
Yeah, got you.
All right. So roll resourceful beard.
Whoa.
Is it a good roll? Did I miss
double
it?
Double sixes.
Double deuce.
On resourceful All right. beard.
Wow.
Whoa. Wow.
No. All right, nice. So obviously you gain Flaming Death Beard 3. In the period of time that he was distracted by the rabbit that was supposed to come out of his hat, you learned to harness the fire of your beard. What once made you afraid that you would lose the source of your power, instead you have turned to your own advantage, and you can now keep your beard alight.
Awesome.
And like use beard. It as you would. So you... grab him by the arms and force your body further onto the gun part of the bayonet.
Don't worry, I'm gonna cauterize the wound later with my beard.
It's dull, so it hurts a lot.
Yeah.
And you shove your beard face up into his face. And you rolled really well. So the darkness beneath his hat reveals itself to be the face of a small doll with one eye that doesn't like close all the way. It's like sort of blinky and open. There's no apparent way that he
deserves
could speak.
To be set on fire.
You
right?
see that for a moment before the flesh of it starts to bubble underneath the onslaught of a fiery beard. And he crumples to the ground, his clothes now empty, as a green mist begins to flow out the door of the ticket tent.
Yeah.
Wow. All right.
How are we doing on time, Dom?
You got 5 minutes.
All right.
All right.
Let's nail it.
Okay.
Drive it home, guys. Green
guys,
mist.
We got to get that mist.
Yep. Got to get that
okay,
mist.
I'm gonna what take are we doing with the mist?
Murphy, take one of your snake oil bottles. Trap it in a bottle.
Okay, roll
with
for that.
Trap it in a bottle.
Don't crap in a bottle. Trap it in.
That's not what I said. Don't crap in a bottle.
Pooping in a
it
bottle.
It sounded like you said crap in a bottle.
Can I have that one? So you rolled 8 and 12?
Yeah.
And I got a 10. All right, you cauterize your wound front and back with the beard on your face.
I know this seems, it's a really long beard.
It's very disturbing to watch.
This seems like gas analyzing, but it's not. I want to capture it in a bottle. The mist.
The mist.
In a potion bottle.
Why would I think that that was gas analyzing?
I don't know.
It's like gas capture.
Yeah. Different. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. You're gonna try.
Capture.
You're gonna try and stopper the mist in a bottle.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay. Do you have any skill that's going to help you with that?
No.
Okay.
This is a fresh one.
Then do it.
This is a fresh one.
Roll.
I didn't make it.
Nope.
Nope.
Damn.
So you try and grab it, and your vial just goes right through it. Because apparently this mist doesn't work that way. I'm not saying all mist doesn't, but this one does not.
Not so much.
This
yeah.
one does not.
Didn't think so.
I'm going to attempt to cast with my magic wand a tarp to, you know, how the thing, and it shoots out, and then it'll catch the mist.
Yep, roll for that. I know exactly what you mean.
Yeah.
That is a classic wand
That
move.
Is a classic yeah. wand move.
This can wand
we,
has been.
Can we just get a tarp?
Nope. There's no time. So she casts out with her wand, attempting to summon forth a tarp, and instead knocks over the ticket booth tent, which does fall on top of the mist. Oh, so God. In a way, it worked, didn't it?
Yeah. Yes. That just, was exactly what I was trying to
just
do.
Just as you planned.
Just as I planned.
So now the mist is trapped beneath the deflated tent.
I am almost
and
positive.
And I want to spend a point because I rolled a 6.
Oh, yeah.
You'd have to spend 2 points, right? Because you rolled yeah. 2. Or wait.
No, she
no I rolled 1
yeah,
6.
Yeah, spend 1 point.
Yeah. To upgrade my magic wand to...
dig deep, Jordan.
Don't do that, because then I'm just going to come up with, like, wand stuff. Where's Nick? If only he wasn't mad at me, I could get he's really good at coming up with these. True. If only he didn't have a blood feud with me now. wand,
yes.
Wish fulfillment 3.
Wish fulfillment.
Wand wish fulfillment 3. Okay, so he is now trapped beneath, okay. Where the mist is trapped beneath a ticket. Take the tent.
Yeah, I'm almost positive there is a buried cable here.
Buzz?
If that was true, that would be some surprising electrical knowledge.
Yeah. I swear to God.
No. When we set this up, I am pretty sure I saw a sign over there that said there was a buried cable. If I am able to pull this cable up, it could make contact
Buzz,
with the edges of the tarp.
You don't have knowing there are signs.
Light the tarp on fire.
Make a roll for the sign.
The sign?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Because you painted this sign. Now, do you have a sign painting skill?
No.
Okay.
I have knowing that there are signs.
Right. Okay. Now you have a sign painting skill. Sign painting skill. So now make a roll to see if you accurately interpreted that sign.
Okay. That's probably just one die then, huh?
Nope.
No.
But.
Are we in the tent or are we outside?
No, you're outside of the tent.
The tent is no longer.
I can light that on fire.
The tent moved and then is now on top of the mist.
Of the green mist, yeah. which is.
Oh,
which
I
is,
can set that shit on fire.
You can start digging though.
Yeah, I'm gonna start digging.
You might have make something
I like
wrong,
how enthusiastic you are about fire.
Good
yeah.
happens.
Like, I can set that on
Don't
fire.
Don't worry, guys. I got this.
Do you want to roll for that?
I can also detect if it's flammable.
Paralyzer.
Insecurity.
Yes.
No. Hold on. First, roll to see if something wrong but effective happens. And if it doesn't, then we'll roll for paralyzing.
Okay, all right, hold on. There we go. Okay.
All right.
13.
Buzz begins digging as Juliet advances on the tent, lit beard ready to ignite it. And Buzz finds a tree root, which he begins to pull. And a young he pulls mightily with all of his strength, and a young sapling just outside the grounds of the carnival that none of you can see disappears into the ground with the sudden force of his mighty yanking on this root. And he continues with one swift movement to pull the tree root all the way through and somehow ends up with a pile of firewood just on top of the tent. Don't ask me how.
Yes.
Wow.
It was wrong entirely, but surprisingly effective. Yeah. But it's young wood. It's not gonna light by itself. You're gonna need some sort of flammable substance, like unsafe carnival paint, in order to light it up.
Does anybody have? Oh!
Don't
make me detect flammable stuff. Sorry.
Here is my paint. Do I have to roll for this?
Yes, you do.
What?
Because earlier you tried painting? To throw paint, but that could have been all of it.
Having unsafe
sign painting?
Paint.
No. What would you paint onto the wood?
Fire here.
Go for it. with the guidance provided by the carnival face painter, you know exactly where to stick your beard. You stick it right on that word. Fire here. Two words.
Oh, it's not a word. It's
I'm sorry.
Interpretive.
The interpretive image that screams to you, fire here. And light the tent ablaze. You hear the shrieks of 1,000 baby dolls.
Baby
probably.
Dolls.
What does that sound like?
Real bad. And the tent withers and blackens, leaving just a patch of scorched earth and nothing else.
Wow.
As day begins to break, over the carnival of forgotten souls, unfortunate name, but that's what it's called, kind of gives away the twist. Mm. You guys live to continue to carny another day.
Great.
And Jingle Jangles comes out. She's, you know, still alive because she was never, you know, alive to begin with. Yeah. Great job, guys. I mean, we're a little behind on our kid soul quota because of this whole fiasco, but right. I really feel like if we all pull together as a team, we can really make today and tonight a successful one. Mm-hmm. So go get some rest. You earned it. But then after that, I'm going to need your help cleaning all this shit up. The end.
Yay.
Yay.
You did it. And only one person got shot in the eye this whole game session, not counting the person who I also shot in the eye the last game
it's
session.
It's one per session, so.
Well, I'll be gone after this one for a brief break before we come back, and I'll continue violating people's eyes with their darts.
Yeah. Honestly, Dom, you actually caught me in the eye earlier. I just didn't say
Uh-oh.
It. Oh. Not just me.
Fortunately, just me. It was one of the little ones.
Yeah.
So thank you, guys. Thank you guys
Good
for
job.
Hanging out for Roll for Shoes. Thank all of you for coming and playing.
Yes.
And thank you for your donations. It's all going towards the Children's Miracle Network Hospitals, which is a great, great cause. So continue to hang out. Watch the rest of the marathon. We got Goblin Quest up next.
Mm-hmm. And no one got on to my compulsion.
Oh, right.
Were you supposed to be mean to Buzz?
Convince Tyler subtly that you're mad at him until he says something.
Okay. It worked. Moshe tried mightily. He was just too chipper.
He was just
too cheery.
He was just like, everyone hates me. Yeah. That's what it is.
He's used to it.
I know.
It has like, so got a point.
That's true. I am miserable.
Yep. You're the worst.
That was my, all right. Well done.
Good.
Bravo.
Right.
That was hard.
It was. It was hard.
I'm so likable.
Yeah, that's why it was hard. That's the reason.
All right, thanks.